The United States and NASA have been at the forefront of using math, science, and engineering to conquer the world's most complex problems for over 40 years. All across the globe, you'll find examples of innovation in science and engineering developed by NASA. Those innovations have led to technologies that impact our daily lives. But now, that unique legacy is at risk. American students are losing ground to the rest of the world in the areas of science and math, which are the building blocks to innovation in engineering and technology. In response to this crisis, NASA has embarked on a new critical mission: improving education in science, technology, engineering, and math, or STEM, across the country.
3, 2, 1, take off.
One goal was to create a program that's sustainable. The teachers would develop a relationship with the researchers and feel comfortable interacting and asking them questions, developing their lesson plan further, really developing an interest in engineering, and then translating that interest to their students.
NASA provided 16 U.S. middle and high school teachers the unique opportunity to work directly with its researchers and gain hands-on experience with its latest aerospace engineering and simulation technologies.
It was fantastic. Two of the best weeks that I've ever spent.
It was amazing. I love being able to actually work with and talk to, you know, actual engineers and scientists that are out there. I spend so much of my time in the classroom, you know, trying to get these kids ready to do that kind of thing. And I think it's a lot more genuine if I have the experiences to bring back to them and be able to say, hey, this is what's really going on out there.
The main goals were to offer professional development to teachers, to expose them to model and simulation that they can use in their classroom, expose them to the scientists and engineers that are actually using model and simulation in the work that they do, and then have the teachers develop lesson plans specific to the courses that they're going to be teaching in the fall.
So the unit that we've prepared is for the kids to look at iRobot's Roomba, make some measurements, analyze what it's doing, and then use a computer simulation to see could we make its trajectory or its path around the room more optimized. I think it's something that's really going to appeal to them. I mean, even a basic simulation like this gets them to, you know, design themselves. They get to change the variables. They get to control the situation. And I think that being able to control things when they're learning is something that appeals greatly to students.
If teachers have a better understanding of what they're teaching, then it makes it much easier for them to show their enthusiasm and excitement to the students.
If half the students in the U.S. got to see half of what I saw, we wouldn't have a problem with students going into engineering or science fields anymore.
This critical link between science, technology, engineering, and math in the classroom is more crucial than ever because 15 of the 20 fastest growing occupations projected for 2014 require significant mathematics or science.
To remain competitive globally, basically we need to continue to innovate and develop new technologies that add value to society. So if you look at STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, the engineering is really where you bring all of those disciplines together and create new value.
Through the modeling and simulation workshop, NASA is engineering positive changes for teachers, their students, and our country. Together, we can make a difference.